Thank you very much, and thank you for inviting us to talk here. I'm proud because I did both a bachelor and master's degree in the Technion, and I think it's a great institute for technology. So Raju actually gave a very good presentation, and what Mellanox does, we work very closely with VMware, and we'll go through some of the solutions that we do. We work with other partners as well. So first, it's pretty obvious. The cloud will touch all of us. Basically, anyone that lives in this century will use the cloud, will touch the cloud, and will actually sometimes depend on the results we get from the cloud. The future of compute and storage and a lot of other services will be everything on the cloud. It will change the way we do information technology. And I think people talked about this previous. And what it'll provide is the most efficient way to find, to know, to make conclusions out of a lot of data that's out there. And it's a great place to innovate. And now it's an inflection point because, as you will see, there's a lot of things to change, to work with, and make new innovations. Basically, we're seeing the change of way computing is working. You know, there was the mainframes that Raghu mentioned earlier. We then moved to a client server way of working, so everybody has his laptop, and there was a back room with all of the Oracle, SAP, Microsoft SQL database, and now you want to have all of the data accessible to you 24 hours, and you don't want to miss anything. It's funny, if you think of that, I don't know if you flew with on airlines that have Wi-Fi, but think, you're about 31,000 feet in the air, and then the Wi-Fi goes for 5 seconds, you hear your neighbor complaining. And to me, it's a miracle, right? You're 30,000 out there, you can see videos, you can get data, you're connected, and we don't even think that this is something that's science fiction. But this is how people are now starting to get used to getting data all the time. When you fly, when you're in boats, everywhere, you're always connected, and you will be very soon connected to the cloud. So there's a problem. You know, today, the way that IT scales is pretty slow. All of the traffic goes into one room, the processing to find the data. The solution will be to have actually unlimited resources for both compute, storage, and networking. So what you want to use is use the resources when you need them, not pay for them all the time. So you actually scale and you pay as you want to, in a granularity that's very small. And the cost for computing and storage is decreasing dramatically. So if in the past you had to own your server, and by the way, the server per application and the storage per the data that you're storing, today you don't do that, you just pay for the floating point operations per second you use, you pay for the bytes you store, you pay for the network you do, and for the service level agreement. So you don't pay a lot of overhead for everything you want to use. It's a very different business model for all of us. So there's a future of doing business is moving to the cloud. There's multiple ways. There's the internal cloud within the corporation. There's the external cloud, and obviously there's big corporations that will use both internal and external cloud for their data centers. I think, like been mentioned before, there are three models. There's software as a service, where actually what you get is the application that runs, and you just connect to that software. There's infrastructure as a service, where you can actually run your application in your data center, but when you want more servers or more storage, you go out there and you get infrastructure. And there's a platform as a service where actually you don't have any hardware, you don't have any platforms inside your premises, everything's outside, and you get the whole platform, and the application can run outside, connected to the application running on your mobile device. This changes the way that networking is done. So like you've seen in the previous presentation, Intel is taking care of the x86, there's a lot of movement now about the memory. You see a lot of flash-based storage hierarchy solutions coming out. EMC is doing a lot of things. Fusion I.O., you heard EMC just made an acquisition here in Israel, Extreme I.O. But basically, the three elements of compute and storage, so compute, memory, where I include flash in the memory, and then the interconnect, need to scale and change the way we do things, because the size of the problem, the way we need to deal with that, changes when we move to the cloud. So if in traditional data center, you had a very defined structure of how data is being moved, and most of it's been moving north-south and not east-west, it was a traditional way of building network. You had the top of the rack, the core, aggregation, and then the core. What you'll see in the cloud is actually a complete change of the data movement. You know, just VMware mentioned vMotion, where you want to move a whole virtual machine from one physical machine to another physical machine. You need a lot of data, and you want to do it very fast. So if in the past 80% of the traffic moved north-south, today 75% of the traffic is east-west, and it's within the same cluster. If before, the latency was not that significant because you could wait, right? You had to process the data, you get the results, you present them. Today, latency is extremely important. If you wait on your iPhone or Samsung or whatever more than 10 seconds, the probability of closing a transaction is very small. If it's less than 10 seconds, the probability of closing the transaction is increasingly higher, and that's what's important. So latency, instead of moving to 100 microseconds, 5 microseconds is becoming a slow network in a lot of things. The oversubscription is unacceptable anymore. It translates to latency, it translates to bottleneck. You don't want to have that. And then you want to scale to hundreds of thousands of servers in one data center. You know, people today talk about tens of thousands. We're now working with multiple entities that are deploying multiple tens of thousands and are talking even to a larger number in one data center. Those are problems that of scale that is a new technology needs to be developed. So what you want is to build a very flat, very fat interconnect to solve those problems. Otherwise, you'll create bottlenecks. Otherwise, the latency will increase. And if you don't have that, you'll create unwanted, undesired issues. You know, in some cases, in one of the stock exchanges, they had enough compute power, they had enough storage power, but the trade nearly stopped for more than 5 seconds because the network could not hold the amount of transactions that spiked because of some event, financial event in Europe. The whole data center for that stock exchange nearly stopped just because there was not enough bandwidth, and the latency increased exponentially with that, and the network is becoming the center problem for a lot of those things. I won't go into all of those things. I want to more concentrate, and I've been asked to cut 5 minutes. So, but if you look at the cloud, there are many issues, and VMware is doing a lot of what you see here under the water, what's the kind of invisible part of the cloud. But there's a lot of problems that are being solved either by software, by hardware, and I think the combination or the synergies between the software and the hardware from the silicon up to the application is getting closer and closer, and we're putting both Intel, Mellanox, and other companies are putting specific mechanisms inside our silicon devices to support the cloud, to support the management of the cloud, to support the security of the cloud, the partitioning, the billing, and you know, all of the things that we need to deal with. If we don't put this in the silicon, it'll be very hard for the software to offer those services or those capabilities to their customers. So just some examples is data security, that we can partition the network in a very robust way with very secure keys, both remote and local keys, service level agreements, and more that people can use and utilize to manage, provision, and secure their stuff. Management is a big issue, because when you scale, you need to understand that you don't want to add a lot of people, human resources, to manage the cloud. You want to be able, I think I've seen the slide, one person to manage thousands of, not tens of thousands, of machines and storage. So management's becoming an issue. You need to do self-healing. You need to be able to identify future problems and then move the virtual machines from one place to another. People today are even talking about having multiple sites that collaborate between them for load balancing, whether they're in Europe, in the US, and West and East Coast. So the self-service model is very attractive, and we're working with a number of people to do this. Fast storage distribution is a very big problem with the amount of data we're seeing. What we're seeing now is a very interesting new way of doing computer storage architecture, where there's a very dynamic hierarchical storage architecture. So there's obviously the cache inside the CPU, is the DRAM outside. Now people put a lot of flash cards inside the server. So that's the first level of storage, or it can be just a cache. Then people are talking about putting a second box outside that's also just flash because of the latency and the bandwidth that you can get out of that box. Only then you will get to the disk, where if you look today, the disk is sitting inside the server. So this is now going to change. You will probably have a very small disk or something like that in the server. You'll have only flash. You'll have another flash box outside, disk, probably slower disk, and then tape. So this storage architecture first is interesting. You can do a lot of services around this, and the latency of finding what you want and making sense of the data inside there is very attractive, and a lot of people are working on this. We're working with VMware and Greenplum EMC to build a big data appliance in Las Vegas to solve exactly some of those problems. Performance and energy. I don't know if you know, but I think Facebook operating expenses, 35% of that is electricity bill. So power consumption is an exceptional expense to a lot of those companies in the cloud, in the big data issues. And if you can move data with less watt per gigabit, it's very significant. And you want to control the amount of power being utilized per second per the amount of jobs and storage you're using on the cloud. So the network is becoming very, important strategic element inside the cloud. We're connecting, you know, between the servers, the storage, the application on top of that, and then eventually to the users that are sitting outside of the cloud. If you look at this, the interconnect efficiency determines the return on investment from the cloud infrastructure. So the name of the game of the cloud is efficiency and utilization. Because if it costs you $10 to serve a user because of the amount of servers you need, the amount of storage and the interconnect, the power and so on, the air condition, space, and another guy costs to maintain the same user is $5, he will take the business away. So the utilization of the compute, the storage, the network is what determines the efficiency and obviously the return on investment for managing the cloud. And you will be surprised how much the interconnect influences or determines the cost of utilizing your infrastructure. What we see here, I think Raghu also talked about, is the scale in the data center. What you see in gray here is the x86 increase of CPU cores. What you see in green is the legacy Ethernet bandwidth with the same years. Today we're talking about 10 gigabit per second as the popular Ethernet bandwidth out there. Mellanox VPI, we'll soon talk about what that means, virtual protocol interconnect, which means both InfiniBand and Ethernet. Or before that, let's talk about PCI Express. That's the bus that's connecting the CPU to outside, scaled in a very nice way with the CPU, because otherwise you have a lot of bottlenecks. And what we've done at Mellanox is we took our Ethernet and InfiniBand bandwidth and scaled it together with the CPU cores so that now you have a balanced architecture between the CPU, the PCI Express, and actually the whole data center, as opposed to only having 10 gigabit per second here. And I think Raghu mentioned that in 2014, I think, the 40 gigabit per second in and out of a 3,000 server will be the standard. We're starting to deploy 56 gigabit per second today in and out of servers. Some of them are actually even lower cost than that in very large data centers. You see a very similar graph in the number of messages rate per second versus the CPU. And again, you see that the limiting factor for utilizing the CPU, if you don't have the right number of messages per second, will be your network. So the network is the limiting factor for utilizing your server and your storage platforms in a very severe way. And we at Mellanox have been able to provide the most efficient interconnect. We'll see some numbers in a second to solve that problem, and the return on investment, people get sometimes 10x, sometimes 20x performance improvements using this interconnect. So what we do at Mellanox, this is maybe going to specifics, but I think it's important, is what we've done is the applications sit up here, and what we provide is networking, storage, clustering, and management with acceleration engines. By the way, acceleration engines here include also virtualization, like SRIOV and other virtualization mechanisms. And then we go either through Ethernet or InfiniBand. The application is completely agnostic whether they run on top of InfiniBand or Ethernet. That's what we call virtual protocol interconnect. So people can feel very comfortable using Ethernet as they've done in the past decades. Whether it's standard, we also have 40 gigabit Ethernet. Or they can run the new InfiniBand standard, which gives them some more juice and some more performance. We have the same capabilities on top of our switches. So every switch at Mellanox, every port that comes out can be either InfiniBand or Ethernet, can also be fiber channel in some cases. So every port that comes out has a VPI capability, so you can run InfiniBand Ethernet. By the way, they can also bridge and route between Ethernet and InfiniBand. So what we've done is we've developed a whole set of silicon products for the switch and the endpoint, boards that plug into the servers or designed on the motherboard, switch platforms from 1U to 21U, basically a lot of bandwidth here, cables and software to enable you to have a full end-to-end solution. So you can actually sleep very good at night when you connect with Mellanox from PCI Express within one box through our device endpoint, cables, switches, to the storage, whether the storage is inside the server or outside the server, and obviously the software on top of both the endpoint and the switch. And this is the most efficient way to connect today in those data centers, and more people are finding out, and thus the growth of our volume shipments and obviously also the revenues, that we're seeing more applications, we'll talk about them in a second, that use this network in their data centers. So talking about virtualization, what you really want to do is put more virtual machines, and we're going to talk about 200, but today the number is more like 20. What we're finding out is, again, that the I/O is becoming the bottleneck for putting a number of virtual machines on top of one physical server. And it has to do with the number of storage accesses or data sharing between servers or moving virtual machines between each other. What we've been able to do with our VPI is increase significantly, and sometimes by 4x, the number of virtual machines being put on top of one physical server. And this is just one example. When you want to put 10,000 virtual machines in a data center, what's the cost of using it with 10 gigabit Ethernet off-the-shelf solution, with Mellanox's 10 gigabit Ethernet? And the reason here we're doing this is because we have RDMA, so the latency and the bandwidth that we can provide to both the computer and storage is better. And then moving today, we also have 40 gigabit per second end-to-end infrastructure. If you look at the numbers, they're very impressive. So we can actually save more than 50% of your cost, the total cost of your networking, and you still be able to deploy 10,000 virtual machines with only 10 top of the rack, 4 aggregation switches. Number of servers goes down from 500 to 200 because the utilization and the efficiency of the servers is dramatically increased. And look at the power consumption. Basically, we save you a significant amount, more than half of your cost for doing the same infrastructure for 10,000 virtual machines. Now, those are real numbers. Those are not, you know, theoretical numbers. Those are numbers that we're measuring with customers and partners around the world. Another way to present this is through the high-performance computing market, where what we see here is the efficiency of the servers, of the systems, using Ethernet. Down here, you see it's about 50, 60%, and those are very high-end systems. So those are very well utilized in the industry today. The average, I think, is more around 25% utilization. What we've done is we took the same servers, the same infrastructure, so basically the same CPU, same DRAM, and so on, but we've increased the efficiency from 50, 60% to more like 80, 90% system efficiency and utilization. That's exactly the strategic difference that we bring with the Interconnect to such high-performance computing platforms. And by the way, if you look at the cloud, it's a supercomputer. If you look at the advantage that Google, Facebook, Apple, and other have, is that they've built a supercomputer inside their data centers that can serve tens of millions of users in one data center, or multiple. What we're seeing with applications or different type of software that serve the Web 2, we're seeing from 2x, 13x performance improvements with Hadoop and Memcached. And we're actually improving, and I think we'll see better performance. And this is pretty significant for the social network guys or the Web 2 application guys that want to deploy servers to serve you as a user. We see the Interconnect also now go into the Microsoft world, into Windows, and we're seeing a very significant increase of 10x performance improvement. 10x is really a number we've seen in multiple applications, but people are seeing this is a new file system that will be announced pretty soon. Windows 2012 is about to release, I think, in the next few month or a quarter and so. But it's a tremendous improvement over any other file server, commercial file server that's been out there in the recent years. Again, with VMware, with 40 gig Ethernet and InfiniBand, we're seeing significant more virtual machines that can be put together on top of one physical machine. We're building today, you know, one of the largest infrastructure out there that will be connected with PCI Express Gen 3 and InfiniBand, and I think we'll see very good results in the coming quarters. Even in regular data centers with structured database such as Oracle, Microsoft SQL, and others, we're seeing a very significant improvement, and thus the results. We talked about storage, but if you look inside those boxes, there's also a network, what we call the back-end fabric for storage. So what users usually see is the front-end that connect the storage systems to the servers, to the customers. Those today are mainly fiber channel and Ethernet. What we also, and by the way, we provide some of those front-end network interfaces, both Ethernet and InfiniBand. But what's even more interesting is what's happening inside those boxes, the back-end interconnect. InfiniBand is becoming the de facto standard for back-end storage interconnect by all those companies and more. In terms of future, where we're going from here, you know, a lot of people ask us, do people need 40 gigabit or 56? The transition or the migration from 40 gigabit per second InfiniBand to 56 is we believe that within 4 quarters, the majority of our customers will move from 40 gigabit InfiniBand to 56, and they're paying a lot of money to do that. People today are already waiting, and I'm talking about Web 2 guys, cloud guys, for 100 gigabit per second solutions because they can utilize the bandwidth. They can use that with the Intel CPU and the DRAM and flash capability. We'll take the latency down, and then in 2017, we'll go to the next generation, which we are starting to investigate and research today. Basically, Mellanox is today in the front of the leading edge technology, whether it's the silicon, the physical interconnect, the software on top of that, the management, the security, the cloud and virtualization on top of that. We're basically looking into 6 segments that will feed our growth in the coming years. It's obviously the high-performance computing, the Web 2 that we're growing very fast, database into enterprise, this is structured database, cloud where the big data is also here, financial services, and storage is an overlay growth segment for us. So let's see, we're touching the most interesting applications and infrastructure challenges in the data center today. You know, obviously, we're located in Israel here. We're trying to build a cloud capabilities here. There's not too much infrastructures as a cloud in Israel. We're working with a number of entities. I think we're looking for more companies to collaborate together and build something like this. We're very open in terms of providing infrastructure and working together with whether it's a technology or a user company, and we think it's important to do it here as well. With that, I think I give you more than 5 minutes. Thank you very much.